Hello, everyone, and welcome to Journey with the Kellers. My name is Amanda Keller, and today we are going to discuss the fourth day that we spent on our Halloween vacation to Disney World. But we actually didn't go to Disney World on this day. We actually went to Universal to go do their Halloween Horrors Night. Now, since the Halloween Horrors Night wasn't until later on in the evening, it started, I think, at 6:30, if I remember correctly. But it also, since we had just been there in December and we had ridden all the rides and stuff, we decided to take that morning to just kind of chill out. They actually, I think, went and played arcade games in the hotel and stuff. So we just kind of had a chill morning. We slept in a little bit. And so we didn't actually go to, Universal until I think it was after lunch. And I had tickets to both sides. So when you do Halloween Horror Nights, you have to buy tickets to Halloween Horror Nights, and those tickets only get you into the Halloween Horror Night, which is on the Universal side of the park, not in Islands of Adventure. So Islands of Adventure still does its regular stuff while Halloween Horror Nights is going on. But since Halloween Horror Nights was in the actual Universal Studios, where Diagon Alley and stuff is, we wanted to go a little bit early and go to the Islands of Adventure side so that we could do Hogsmeade and stuff like that. And that so that the my husband and stuff could ride some of the other rides. So mainly while we were there on the Islands of Adventure side, me and my daughter Leah went and did Hogsmeade. And then my daughter Hope and my husband went and rode rides. Leah didn't really want to ride rides that day. She wanted to go shopping at Harry Potter. So, me and her headed over there. Now there was, there is no, like the Halloween Horror Nights isn't allowed to go on in the Harry Potter part. So even during the Horror Nights, there wasn't any like scary things going on in Diagon Alley, except for the Death Eaters were there. And they weren't so-called scary. It was just kind of entertaining. So we just kind of went for a few hours to the Islands of Adventure. We had dinner while we were there, and then we left there and went over to the Universal side and did Horror Nights. So here's just some of the pictures from what, being over in Hogsmeade and stuff. I don't really have any pictures of the rides or anything because, like I said, we didn't really ride them. And I didn't do photos of my husband and Hope doing them. It's mainly of Hogsmeade. So I apologize for that. So I'll be back in just a minute. Okay, so that's it for the pictures for that part of the park. Now, you did see in there, like, there was kind of pictures of, like, an old ancient place that kind of looked like, and there was, like, a big hand and a big sword and stuff like that. That was actually the ride Poseidon's Fury, which actually was closed in 2023, so it was the last ride that was still available in that section of the Universal Park, or of the Islands of Adventure Park. I forget the name of that section, but where Poseidon's Fury is at in the park, that was the last ride that was available in there. So now it's just shops and stuff in that section, which is kind of sad. I don't know if they're going to replace some rides in there or what's going to happen. I do know that Universal is building a whole new park. I think they're supposed to be opening in 2025. So I don't know if they're going to renovate some of the other stuff too, while they're at it or not. So that was basically it. Now, we did also ride because we were there at Christmas time last year, but we didn't really, we went into the kiddie part of the park, but we didn't actually ride any of the rides or anything. But there was this really cool like train thing that kind of goes around, and it's kind of elevated. It's up in the air and it kind of goes around the little kiddie section of the park. And so we decided to ride that. We thought, oh, cute, slow little train ride. And we got on there, and it was actually kind of fast. And there was a part where you were like going over water, and I mean, there's like nothing below you. It's just this little thin track, and you in this car. It's a little bit scary. So if you're afraid of heights, it would probably have been worse. I'm not too bad, but every once in a while, you know. So that was it for Islands of Adventure. Like I said, I didn't really take a whole lot of pictures here because one, we weren't there very long. And two, because we just did all this at Christmas time. So you can actually go back and watch the Christmas videos of when we went to Disney World and stuff. And you'll see a bunch of the Universal Studios pictures on there if you would like to do that. So then next we went to Islands of or over to Universal to do Halloween Horror Nights. And again, my husband and Hope went off and did some of the haunted houses. Now, we didn't do very many. We were not staying there very late. We just basically wanted to go see it. And my daughter, Hope, wanted to do some haunted houses. She had never really done any. So this was our way of letting her go. Me, I don't really care about haunted houses. Even some of the things, like they had things, you know, scare zones that you had to walk through and stuff. It didn't really scare me. I think I have too much of a brain to think, yeah, you're so fake. I just can't get around that it's not real. And so, although I do scare easily, but if I know the scares are coming, it's not scary to me. So that's, you know, not much point in me going through a haunted house or anything else, because I actually a lot of times end up getting bored. I know that sounds bad, but it's just the way it is. So me and Leah once again went off and went to Diagon Alley, and we walked around there. And then Hope and my husband Joe met us there so that they could see some of the stuff over there. But me and Leah went into like every shop in Harry Potter. So on the Hogsmeade side and on Diagon Alley, we went into every shop. We went into every little like eating little thing, like the ice cream shop and all of that. We didn't go into like the big sit down eating things just because we weren't doing that. But, yeah. So, I mean, we went into everything that we could. There were a few shops that weren't open, but that's okay. And we did get to see the Death Eaters, which was pretty cool. So I'll go ahead and put those videos up and stuff and some of the, in the pictures up from that. And then, I'll be back to, in this video. It's not a very long one today just because we weren't doing an all day thing. So I'll be back in just a minute.
Look in front of you, Hope.
Thank you. Yeah.
you guys. So that was the end of our trip to Universal, and we ended up going home. Now, I will tell you, this is where the kind of sickness started. My daughter, Leah, that was with me, walked by a stand that has, you know, they have ice and then they put the drinks in there and you can just pick a drink out of the ice and pay for it or whatever. And she just happened to walk by and swiped a piece of ice and stuck it in her mouth. Now, the guy who was doing the stand tried to say, hey, that ice isn't clean. But it was already too late. She had already put it in her mouth. Now, I can't blame her. This is something she does all the time. She actually works for an ice company. So it was just habit to swipe a piece of ice and eat it. For some reason, my kids, all of them, like to just get a glass of ice and eat ice out of it. So, yes, it was her fault for not thinking, but also it was just habit to just pick up a piece of ice. So the next morning, she actually woke up with a really bad sore throat, which ended up in me getting a really bad sore throat. And here I am like 3 weeks later and still kind of fighting it. I think it's basically up in my sinuses and it's kind of stuck there. But hopefully it'll be, it's definitely better, but hopefully it'll be going away here within the next week or so. So that's where the sickness started. Now, we don't know for sure that the ice is what caused her to get sick, just because, I mean, that happened like late afternoon and she was sick with a sore throat by the time she woke up the next morning, which kind of is not enough time really for it to maybe have been caused by the ice. So we're not sure. But either way, that's where the sickness started. So, but anyway, so that was it for Universal. Me and Leah tried all the butter beers. We tried it hot. We tried it cold. We tried it iced. We did all this different stuff with it. And then we tried different things while we were there. Leah bought a whole gob of stuff. I bought a couple of wands and some earrings for Hope. And so we just had a good time. Joe and Hope went through some of the haunted houses. Hope really liked them. Joe, not so much as impressed. He said they weren't as scary as he expected them to be. But, you know, I mean, he did all that stuff as a teenager and a young man. And so he's older now and maybe it just doesn't affect him the same way as it does, you know, like the younger generation who haven't done all that all the time. But, you know, the whole point was to be able to just go see it and to have a good time. And we did. So it doesn't matter. So that's it for today. I hope you all enjoyed this video. Like and subscribe if you like, or don't if you don't. It's up to you. Everybody have some good holidays. Have some good vacations. Have good everything. Enjoy your days. Enjoy your life. And we'll see you later. Bye.